And now we will learn all about flipping properties. This is video one in a series of three videos regarding flipping properties. And in this video, we will learn about buying a property. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What does flipping property mean? It means you buy a property, then you renovate the property, and then you sell it for a profit. For the first time in this course, you will now have assets in your chart of accounts. And you may well ask, what is an asset? Well, it's something you pay for that has value well after you pay for it. So let's clarify. At the moment you pay for something, if you already used the value at the moment you pay for it, that's how you know you have an expense. And expenses are reoccurring things like delivery, repair, cleaning, and things you always have to pay for to maintain and run your business. However, if at the moment you were paying for something, you were paying for an asset, the value was still there after you pay. So things like a car or equipment or even a building. If you pay for these things at the moment you pay, it still has value that you can use into the future. It's still an asset even if you can't touch it. And that's a very important point. If the asset is intangible or you're paying for some idea, but this idea has value into the future, then it is still considered an asset and it is put into QuickBooks that way. Now, when you buy property, it is a fixed asset type of account in QuickBooks. You usually buy it with a mortgage. You give the down payment to the bank, and the bank gives the mortgage money to the previous owner. So, how do we set up to buy property? Well, first, we have to put the mortgage company on the vendor list. In this case, it's Mighty Mike's Mortgages. From the main menu, click Vendors, Vendor Center. Then in the top left, just like we learned, click Vendor, New Vendor. And just type in Mighty Mike's Mortgages. And then just click OK. And now we have a payee on the list that we can pay the deposit to and make the mortgage payments to. And now we put the fixed asset account in the chart of accounts that represents the property that we're buying, or at least represents the cost of the property that we're buying, 110 Livingston Street, and we put it in as a fixed asset. From the main menu, click List, Chart of Accounts, then in the bottom left, click Account, New. Now, this is a fixed asset major purchase. We click Continue. And we're going to put in Building 110 Livingston Street. That's the name of this fixed asset. Save and close, and now we have the fixed asset on the list ready to use. And now we have to add the mortgage account in the chart of accounts as a long-term liability, and you can just name it Mortgage to Mike. So, account, new, and it's a long-term liability. Click Continue and type in Mortgage to Mike. And that should be enough for us to remember what it is. So, now that we're all set up, we have to ask what happens on the day that we buy the property. Well, cash in bank decreases by the amount of the down payment. We become responsible for a long-term liability, which is the mortgage, and we own the asset that we just paid for. All you have to do to handle all of this is to make one big journal entry. Or you could break it up into two transactions, which is the normal way to do it. For example, let's imagine on October 1, we paid the mortgage company, Mike's Mortgage, check number 2001 for $30,000 for a down payment on the house at 110 Livingston Street. So how do we do that? Well, we already know how to write a check. We can click check from the icon bar, and it's check number 2001, and the people whom we're paying, or the mortgage company, is Mighty Mike's Mortgage, and the date we're paying, I believe the date was October 1, so it just happens to be here in the calendar, and the amount we're paying is $30,000. Now, this was already chosen because I did a warm-up video, but you should know that the account that you're paying for is the new asset that you made. It's the building at 110 Livingston Street. So if you click here and then you click building at 110 Livingston Street, it means you're paying $30,000 for that building. We click save and close, and then we check the trial balance, and you can see cash is greatly diminished. But you can see building at 110 Livingston Street shows up for the first time in the trial balance as $30,000. Now let's imagine that the mortgage company, Mike, gave the previous owner of 110 Livingston Street the $70,000 mortgage that we are now responsible for as the new owners of the property. Well, how would you do that? As I mentioned before, you would make a journal entry. So, if you look at the building right now, you see it showed up normally when we wrote a normal check as the debit side. This implies that the building or the asset would normally be on the debit side. And that's what we're going to put when we record the journal entry. And that will help you remember the amount of the building that you paid for through the mortgage gets put on the debit side, and therefore the balance of the mortgage in the liability account goes on the credit side. From the main menu, we click Company, Make Journal Entry, Make General Journal Entry. And the journal entry window opens up. Just click OK for this. Now, the date that we are assuming responsibility for both the mortgage and the property is really October 2nd. Now, as mentioned, this 110 Livingston Street building showed up on the debit side when we paid for it. By giving the owner the mortgage, we are paying more by $70,000. So it goes on the debit side. That's how you will remember it. If you pay more for it, the debit part goes up. And of course, everybody knows in a journal entry, whatever money amount goes on the debit side goes on the credit side. And you may well ask, what account should we credit for the $70,000? And the answer is the long-term liability mortgage to Mike. So at the moment we assume responsibility of the building, we make a debit for $70,000 to show that we have paid more for this asset, but we acknowledge we owe this liability, we make a credit, $70,000. And if you want to learn more about debits and credits and why we put this the way that we do, you can watch the supplemental videos about debits and credits. In the meantime, click save and close, and don't worry about this, just click OK. And now notice the total you paid for the building was $100,000, and you only have a $70,000 mortgage, and your cash has greatly decreased. And these are the results that you would expect after paying your cash plus assuming a mortgage to buy a building worth $100,000.